Hello and welcome to the BE1 Flex video series. This video is going to show a quick example of how to set a time and instantaneous overcurrent. I'm working offline, so I'm going to go to File, New, and select BE1 Flex to create a new settings file from scratch. Under the Settings Explorer, the first thing I'm going to do is configure my style based upon whatever hardware I'm expecting to use. For this particular application, I'm going to use an M0 analog board, a W9 input-output board, and I'm going to drop E5 Ethernet board as well. At the very bottom is going to be the non-board specifics, such as protocol packages. Once I click Auto Generate Instance, it's going to create, or ask me to create, all the instances related to that hardware configuration. Particularly for this application, we're going to be talking about the circuits and the outputs. You can think of that as an analog to digital conversion from the physical board to the settings availability. So now when I go into my circuits, if I look at that, I can give it a username if I want, and I can see where those physical voltage and current inputs are mapped into that circuit. I can edit those if I wish, but the auto configuration oftentimes will do the job for you. Next, I go to power system for the circuit and enter the PTs and CTs and other nominal settings that apply to that circuit. Under output summary, I can view the outputs I have available. I don't necessarily need to make any changes to this screen, but in this particular application, I'm going to give it a new username just for sake of ease using it later. Next, I'm going to go down to my protection screen, and I'm going to turn on a time and instantaneous overcurrent. I'm going to be calling them phase overcurrents because that's what I'm going to be using them for, but those are just user-defined names, and you can name them as you wish. So once I've created a time and an instantaneous overcurrent, I'll click the status button, and I can turn on and set that function. So I'm going to turn it on as a three-phase, and there's that feeder one circuit name that I had put in earlier. Give it a pickup and a time dial if you wish, and that element has now turned green. I'm going to jump to the time overcurrent, and it's going to be very similar. I can set it as three-phase, look for the source of feeder one. In addition to what the instantaneous overcurrent has, in the time overcurrent, I'm going to be looking at a curve and a time dial. So once I've set that curve, time dial, and pickup point, my graph on the right populates to give me a visual of how that device is set. Finally, I'm going to go to the bottom of my settings and look for the logic. In logic, I'm going to be driving outputs. Another functionality that could be done in this sequence is to drive fault recording. With the default settings of the Flex, the fault recording will happen automatically, so that doesn't need to occur. Similarly with targets. So I'm going to go to my Elements tab and drag over my instantaneous and my time overcurrent. Next, I'm going to go to my Components tab. I could put a notes field in here that can be viewed either later in the settings or even from the relay HMI. Those are optional. And going to grab an OR gate. In most applications, you're going to trip if either condition occur. So finally, I'll go to my I/O tab, and I'm going to get that physical output that I had named earlier, output 1. As you can see, it says trip output on the logic. Finally, I'm going to drag my logic lines around and look in the lower right corner to see my two green dots. That tells me that's a valid settings file. Once I click save, it gives me three green dots, and that's a fully happy and healthy logic configuration based upon the style configuration of this unit. I will save the settings file to my computer, and later I would typically be uploading it to a physical relay. Finally, just to reiterate, the targets have been enabled automatically, so you don't have to do that, as well as the alarms. Critical alarms have been enabled. You can enable and disable as you wish. And sequence of events, load, and fault recording have also been taken care of automatically. That is the quick start of a BE1 Flex setting a time and instantaneous overcurrent. Thank you.